survivors of the Holocaust, museum friends, distinguished guests, welcome to this ceremony and this magnificent rotunda. Some may ask why we remember the Holocaust in this hall of democracy in the capital of the free world. Or for that matter, why is there a Holocaust museum on our National Mall? The answer lies in the fact that this great country was founded on an idea, one of the most consequential ideas in human history. That idea is represented in this majestic space and engraved at one entrance to the museum, where visitors encounter some of the most important words ever written about our national values. They begin, "We hold these truths to be self-evident." The Declaration of Independence was perhaps the very first human rights proclamation, and universal freedom is at the heart of our democracy. This house of a democracy is situated at one end of the mall, and at the other end sits the Lincoln Memorial. Midway between is our museum, whose lessons stand as a cautionary tale in stark contrast to the rest of the mall. As one US senator said shortly after the museum opened, "The Washington Monument has never looked quite so beautiful as it does now that it stands next to the Holocaust Museum." For the Holocaust teaches us that freedom is fragile and that each of us must be vigilant in protecting it. With freedom comes responsibility. Weimar Germany was an advanced, educated nation with a democratic constitution and a free press. That's why the challenge to civilization that the Nazis represented reminds us that it is not enough to cherish our national ideals. We must be ever wary of human nature and constantly work to advance those ideals. Sometimes we must fight and sacrifice for those ideals. Over 16 million Americans fought in World War II, and more than 400,000 gave the ultimate sacrifice in order to defeat Nazism and fascism. As we watch the flags of each of the US Army divisions that liberated the concentration camps enter the rotunda, we remember that the brave young soldiers who freed Europe, ended the Holocaust, and preserved American democracy. To paraphrase General Dwight Eisenhower's stunned reaction upon seeing the newly liberated camp at Ohrdruf, it's important to know not only what we are fighting for, we must also know what we are fighting against. So the young servicemen and women who will shortly present these divisional flags remind us of the catastrophic events of the past and the daunting challenges of the present. On this day of remembrance, we remember the victims and we remember those who liberated them. And we must also remember that today our world faces new threats and a new extremist ideology, and that young Americans are yet again on the front lines of freedom. Thank you.